Okay, so for those of y'all that don't know me, my name is Matt Meschendorf, and this is my capstone project surrounding coaching Christian youth soccer here at school with elementary schoolers. So kind of starting out, I had the same thought process as everybody. I didn't really know what I wanted to do for a capstone. Main reason for that is diversity of interest. If you don't know, I do a lot of things and I'm very busy all the time, so time management was terrible. Ms. New and I talked about that at one point, that we just didn't see any time, really. So we had to find something that fit with my schedule, but also something that I love to do. And throughout my life, I've been involved in music, soccer, and martial arts. So it's just kind of this clump of a little bit of everything. And I didn't really know exactly what path I wanted to take on my capstone. But finally, I kind of had an idea for soccer, because that is something that's carried me from day one. I started playing when I was 4 at AYSO, which is just recreational, so it's very casual play, just kind of coming out to have fun, and it's carried me all the way through to college. At age 12, I started playing competitively with Knoxville Soccer Academy under the coaching of Derek Broadley, and I played at CAK ever since 6th grade. And so this kind of, I didn't realize how much of an impact it had in my life until this capstone project, because you kind of look back and see, well, what has influenced your life so much that it would be worth doing a project on? And soccer just kind of threw itself out there to me, but I had an inspiration for this project, and my inspiration is Coach Derek Broadley, and this man has been, I don't even know how to describe him, one of the most impactful people in my life. He took me in when I signed for KSA, didn't know what I was going to do. I was a new goalkeeper relatively. I played as a striker before. And Derek told me, I remember him quoting this to my parents and everything, give me 5 years with Matt and I can make him the best youth goalie in the state of Tennessee. So that was in 2013, so here I am now. I don't know where I am on that, but I don't know how good that's going to go, but no, Derek had so much faith in me, and he brought me to where I am now, and I credit him with 100% of my success throughout soccer. I mean, he was the one who helped me through college processes and everything. I mean, we talked to him so many times just trying to figure out, how do we start this up? How do we get to where Matt's going to be a college player? So he was just this role model in my life that has stayed with me, and I plan to keep training with him whenever I'm in the off season. So kind of going into it, he makes everything look easy, I'll be honest. This man's been coaching forever. He coached at Fulham, which is a professional team in England, and Crystal Palace, which is another top-tier team in England. And I don't know, he made everything look easy. Every training session was organized exactly to what we needed. So this was kind of my expectation going into it, was relaxed, calm, and I was wrong. I was very wrong. I was working with a group of third graders. I expected, you know, this group of kids that, you know, pretty much knew the game already, and they were ready to learn, ready to advance their skill set. But my hesitations were completely blown away by this. As soon as I realized what I was dealing with, it was about teaching the basics. The energy of the kids was absolutely all over the place. I mean, these people were coming in. These parents were bringing their kids after school, and these were new players. You know, they didn't know the game like I did, like the training sessions I'm used to. They just had a bunch of energy and wanted to play a game. And so I think that was probably my biggest fear, is being able to control the kids and be able to say, hey, look, this is what you need to do here, without their attention going 3 different directions at the same time. So I do have a little bit of experience teaching. I used to be an instructor for Taekwondo, and I'm going back this summer to kind of teach again, because I have a little more time on the off season. So I always knew there was going to be potential for difficult kids, you know, especially in a team setting like that. There's always going to be that one that thinks they're the best, or that's a little difficult, this, that, and the other. I always knew that there was going to be that potential. And then my last concern was just my ability as a coach. Instructing Taekwondo is very different from coaching soccer. Taekwondo is a very controlled environment from the beginning. No matter what you do, even if you're a white belt, you'll learn to stand still and respect the instructor. Soccer, you run a lot more, and these kids are just focusing on the game. The whole point of the game is running. And I didn't really know how much I'd fare in that area. So starting to be a coach, it was a lot harder than I had expected. I didn't know what I was doing, I'll be completely honest. It was just the concept of taking these basics that I haven't learned since I was 4 and 5, taking these basics and reteaching them, because all of the training sessions I'm a part of are intense, pushing you to that physical limit and a little bit over. And that's the point of the training, is so that you can progress just a little bit further every time. But when you have to go all the way to square one and teach these basics to kids that you haven't learned in, you know, 12, 14 years, it kind of all gets cluttered, and you have to figure out ways to explain this stuff on the baseline level. You also have to learn the limit that these kids can handle, because through my training sessions, you know, it's always seemed for me like my limit was here, here, and here. I know exactly what I can do. But figuring that out for eight other kids that don't know the sport, I mean, it's being a coach was more mentally taxing for me than physically taxing. But we did make it through. We had our coaching staff led by Coach John Day. And he really guided me and Sammy through the whole thing, because not only has he coached high school guys, but he's coached middle school girls and elementary schoolers before. So he was able to kind of share that knowledge with us. But it also helped to have another guy there that was my age that was kind of in the same boat as me. So we were, you know, we spent a lot of time, a lot of my hours for the capstone were just us sitting next to each other saying, what are we going to do? How can we make this work? We don't know how to coach. So it was a learning experience more than anything. And it helped to have, you know, Coach Day as a role model as well, just to kind of look and say, look, this is what you need to do. This is how you have to handle these young kids. There's so many different things that you have to do from what I teach you guys in training. And that really became apparent through the difficulties. For privacy reasons, just because, you know, they are at CAK, I'm going to leave the kids' names blank, but we had two difficult kids, and it surrounded competition and fairness. There was one kid that didn't want to partake in any part of the competition, nothing at all. It was very hard to get her up and ready to go for soccer, because it just kind of seemed like her parents threw her into it to give her something to do after school. But at the end of the day, she was a very nice girl. She ended up giving all the coaches gifts, and she ended up learning a lot. By the end of it, she became a very promising player, I think. And so that was kind of cool to see the impact that I made on her life, that me and Sammy had done. The other kid was like polar opposite. He was sitting there. He was ready to go the whole time, thought he was, you know, Ronaldo of the third grade. And he had all this energy, but the one part is he was the one that focused on fairness. He kind of disregarded it. You know, he just kicked the ball away from other people whenever we were waiting in line for anything. And so he would distract from the training session, but he still loved the game so much, and he thought he was the best in the game. So my fear was kind of became a reality, really, with difficult kids, but we ended up learning how to handle them. You know, the girl that wouldn't come to any of the practices, we were like, hey, if you come over here, you'll have a lot of fun. We can teach you something. We can give you a lesson. And, you know, when she found out she'd be taught something, jump right up. So we found out what made her tick, I guess. And then with the other guy who just had no focus, we had to really rein him down. And Coach Day took a big part in that, and saying, look, you have to focus. If you want to be the best, you have to focus and put time and effort into it. And so the biggest thing for me for the value and impact, it taught me a lot of patience. You know, I'd had it from Taekwondo and everything, but this was completely out of my element. It taught me a lot of patience to be able to sit there and say, look, these are the basics for everything. And, you know, it was explaining the basic concept of a pass two or three times that we see in high school training, and it's just normal. You know, it's muscle memory at this point. We can pass a ball 20 yards and get it 9 out of 10 times. But in that process of having to explain things over and over again, it taught me that I love teaching. That's why I signed up for Taekwondo in the first place. I love helping people and being able to make an impact. And it taught me to teach this game that I love, that's carried me so far, that I've had so many good and bad memories with. But overall, I love the game of soccer. And it made me realize that, you know, it's not about trophies and everything. It's about putting the fun back into the game. And I think this was the most valuable lesson I've ever learned. You see it so many times in high school, players are focused on trophies, trophies, trophies. And I'm not going to say that's wrong, because that's what has to happen naturally. As you get older, you get more competitive. But what I remember from my AYSO days is that it was just about going out and playing. You know, I played four different positions. I played all over the field. I'd run and score just to play with my friends. And it was that concept of putting the fun back into something you love, because we get so distracted from that as high school players. we see a 1-0 loss, which we've experienced this season, and it seems devastating to know we were almost there, we could have won the game, and then we didn't, and we go home devastated. But every time I was in AYSO and I saw these kids play, even the team that lost in our little small-sided 3v3 games, they walked off the field happy that they learned something, happy that they did something, and that they accomplished something, and they go running over to their parents telling them, hey, I scored a goal, my team lost, but I still scored. And it's that energy and joy that really, like, I guess gave me a new perspective on soccer as a whole, because even when you go down, you get back up and you see this joy and this bright light that you still did something wrong, you still did something right, and that you can take positives away from it. And that's kind of why I didn't want to stop here. This wasn't the end of my capstone. So I'll admit I did start a little later than I would have liked on my capstone. It just kind of, it fell that way. But this is a continuous capstone. My goal was not to start a camp and leave it. It was to start a program. And Sam has graciously agreed to continue this program as we go on. He will choose a rising junior to help him out and advance this. When we talked about our capstone, it was preparing kids for middle school soccer. That was the end goal that we wanted. We didn't want to just have third graders teaching elementary school soccer. We wanted to be able to grow this thing into preparing for middle school soccer, because I know personally, my transition was really rough. I came from not knowing, you know, anything about the game. It was so rough for me, and it was devastating for me, because I felt like I was so behind. And now, here I am, high school senior playing, and it would have helped, I think it would have helped majorly to have some program as a bridge between elementary school and middle school, because competition is fierce. You go from playing with kids your own age, only playing kids your own age in like an AYSO level, to playing with eighth graders that are 2 feet taller than you are. And so that's kind of our goal for the program, is to be able to provide coaching, and we've talked to Coach Day about this, providing coaching for all different age groups in order to make them ready for that next step. As for me personally, my future, I will be attending Carson Newman as a college soccer player for their Division II side, and I'm super excited about it, couldn't be more happy. But it also makes me realize that after college, and I'll obviously learn a ton about college soccer and soccer as a whole, I want to be a coach later in life. I would love to coach a rec league, an AYSO, nothing too serious, but something just enough to where I can know I'm making an impact on people. And this allowed me to really revisit those AYSO days and realize what an impact those coaches have had on me. And a little bit about the capstone in the future. I don't really have a slide for it, but we have decided that we are going to have mascots walk out with us on our first night of districts. In order to further impact those kids, they looked up to us. We became known as Coach Sammy and Coach Matt. And we want them to see us as more than that. We want them to see us as role models and players, people that they can look up to. So we are going to have mascots walk out with us on the first district game, April 17th, at home versus Grace Christian. We're going to dress them up in CIK t-shirts and everything. For the home team, they're going to have white t-shirts, but the one that walks with me will have a yellow t-shirt for my kid. And we think that that'll be a really good opportunity for them to kind of find out, you know, what's the high school scene like, and to make this lasting impact on them. I wouldn't have changed anything about my capstone. From starting late to getting district games moved to being kind of scrambled for ideas, I wouldn't change a thing, because this taught me so much. This taught me about my love of teaching, made me re-realize exactly what I was capable of and what I wanted to do post-college, you know, alongside a career. I would love to see myself coaching a youth team. I love making an impact on people, and I love trying to be a role model that kids can look up to. So that was the premise of the capstone, and I wouldn't change a thing on it. So I hope you've enjoyed listening, and I hope to see you at that home game.